Good morning. Today we will learn about iodine metabolism. The specific learning objectives for today's session are: enumerate the functions of iodine, discuss the causes and deficiency manifestations of goiter related to iodine deficiency. These are the headings under which we will be learning iodine metabolism. Iodine is an essential trace element. Total body content is about 25 to 30 milligrams. 80% of it is concentrated in thyroid gland and it is seen in thyroglobulin protein. The serum levels of iodine is 5 to 10 micrograms per deciliter. Seafood is the best source or the rich source of iodine. Apart from that, we have iodized salt, that is fortification of salt, very important source of iodine. Drinking water, vegetables, egg, dairy products also have iodine content. Recommended allowance is 100 to 150 microgram per day. Coming to the metabolism, iodine is absorbed from small intestine and it is bound loosely to plasma proteins and it is transported. 80% of this iodine is concentrated in thyroid gland, mainly in thyroglobulins, and 2/3 of it is excreted in urine. Even though all cells can take up iodine, thyroid gland is the only tissue or organ which can concentrate and put the iodine to a higher valency state. Coming to functions of iodine, the main and one important function in the body is it is required for the synthesis of thyroid hormones T3 and T4. Which will be learnt elaborately during thyroid hormone synthesis. This thyroid hormone in turn is used for growth, cell differentiation and development, and also it determines the rate of metabolism in the body. That's why previously this thyroid hormone estimation was used as an indicator of basal metabolic rate. Iodine deficiency, it's an important public health problem and it can be a preventable disease. Iodine deficiency can cause a simple enlargement of thyroid gland, an endemic status usually found in hilly regions known as goiter belt. So simple enlargement of thyroid gland is called as goiter. Low iodine levels affects the synthesis of thyroid hormone, thereby stimulating the secretion of TSH from anterior pituitary. TSH in turn stimulates the thyroid gland to secrete thyroid hormone. This leads to hypertrophy and hyperplasia of follicular cells of thyroid gland, leading to enlargement of thyroid. So this is known as simple goiter. So it can be prevented by use of iodized salts, especially in goiter belt, which can reduce the incidence of goiter. Severe iodine deficiency in a pregnant lady can lead to intrauterine or neonatal hyperthyroidism, which results in cretinism. So there will be dwarfism, slow body movement, characteristic facial features of mental retardation. Apart from that, goitrogens, the substances which interfere with the iodine uptake and thereby disrupt the production of thyroid hormones, also results in hypothyroid states. Cabbage and tapioca, they are very rich in these goitrogens, that is thiocyanates, thereby they might cause hypothyroid state. Iodine toxicity. Paradoxically, excess intake of iodine more than 2 mg per day will result in inhibition of thyroid hormone synthesis, thereby leading to iodide goiter and myxedema. With this, we have come to the end of today's session and we have learnt about the functions of iodine, mainly in synthesis of thyroid hormones, and deficiency manifestations, that is goiter due to iodine deficiency. Thank you.